Heya, welcome back to another one of Adipose's and Luos's scenery tutorials for LittleBigPlanet. Today we're going to be making a boat, as you can see on screen. Now we had a few comments about some of the ways that we make shapes. This is the method we used in the last video when we were making our cave, which is we drew a three-layer shape, three thick layers that is, and then to create the holes in it, to create the gaps, we drew a back layer shape, one layer shape that is, in the back, and then we drew two layer shapes to give the impression that you can see in front of you. So we all did it by drawing, no cutting away at all, we drew everything in. And if you draw on all three layers again, you can create the shapes that we've got here. Now there are disadvantages to this method, and the disadvantages come when you want to edit it afterwards. If you then go to the corner editor and start pulling some of the shapes around, you can see that there's actually nothing behind it, and that can give you gaps. Now that could be the effect you want, which is fine, but if you don't want that, then that could be quite frustrating. So this method's really good when you know exactly the shape you want, when you know you're not going to need to do a lot of editing afterwards. But this is the second method. Here I've got a one layer shape and I've copied it three times and I've stuck it all together. So you could see there on the edge that there were three separate shapes, all one layer thick, all stuck together. Now this time, of course, you don't draw onto it, you cut bits out of it when you want your holes, and you can make those holes one layer, two layer or three layer thick. And you can see me now here, I've cut out one shape, and when you cut it out, you've still got the other two layers behind. So let's get some other shapes, let's cut some holes in to start making this kind of boat shape. So remember, to recap here, we've got three one layer thick shapes, all stuck together, and I'm cutting through them with different layer shapes. This is a two layer cut now that we're going to do to give me different effects. The advantages of this is that I can use the corner edit tool afterwards. It's easier to edit. The disadvantages of this method is it's perhaps harder to do natural landscapes like trees and caves like you saw in the last video, but it probably is easier for man-made items like buildings, factories, etc. Now if I just use the material changer here to separate these three layers so you can clearly see what is made of each layer. Merry Christmas, by the way, a little bit late, but let's go for the metal today. We can turn these into different layers. You can see if I get the corner edit tool, I can still edit each layer individually from the rest, and they're not going to get in each other's way, and I'm not going to leave any awkward gaps behind. So if I just pull this one back, you can see the other layer is still there behind it, and I can pull the other layer forward and there's no problems there. Even when using the corner editor, I would personally keep the grid on. If you copy your original shapes and put them on the thin layer, you can then give yourself a background or even a foreground as well. And again, you can edit them with the corner editor. And so here we can see a boat made by a different method to the last video. So this is the boat we're working on today. We used a combination of the two methods just to make it confusing for you. We made a three-layer boat and then we put a thin layer background on it, but we are going to be using different methods as we go. This is Luos, for those of you that didn't see him from the last video, and please do check out our previous videos if you haven't already. When drawing, it's always good to use a combination of the front view and the game view. The game view gives all of you those wonderful 3D effects, but the front view will show you exactly where you're cutting and exactly what shapes your objects will be. So although it's annoying to keep having to press start, it is good to keep flipping between those two views because then you know you have drawn it correctly. We drew it originally in dissolve, and now we're turning it into wood, so you can see our boat starting to take shape. You don't have to start drawing in dissolve. We normally do with separate objects because I guess that's how we've always done it, and it's easier to draw the shape first and then see how it looks in different materials. So here we can see the advantage of the corner editor there, using different layers. We've got a thin layer on the back. We wouldn't have been able to do that with the old method, but we can do that one now. We're going to hold our boat up with a stiff rod today, so we can unpause without it falling down to the floor. We are going to add some water later, and we'll be trying to make it float. You can look forward to that catastrophe later on. Here we go. Now we're drawing in on the middle layer. We're going to make ourselves a chimney. First of all, starting in dissolve. We're going to get the corner edit tool out, and we're going to try and make it look a little bit like a steamboat. To give this furnace the look we want, we're going to use a combination of fire, we're going to use LEDs, and we're going to try and add some effects to them as well. So we've just put a bit of cardboard in at the bottom, or a bit of dissolve, and we've used the lethalize tool to make it fire. We've put another bit of dissolve above it, which we're going to turn into white gas, which very nicely for us will look like smoke. We're then going to get a couple of LEDs, one orange, one yellow, and we're going to create ourselves a little bit of logic at the bottom. If you turn your magnetic key switches to speed, and then move that switch towards and then away from a key, and connect that to a light, the light will actually get brighter and then duller. So as that piston moves, you can see the light getting brighter and stronger there. We put the LEDs behind the fire. And we've just used the corner edit tool to make the fire itself a bit bigger, and so we get that nice little flicker effect there. I've sped this up. We're not actually going for the epileptic fit route with it. We're just adding a bit of barbed wire or chain link fence in front of it. We're going to add a few little squares, and then we're going to bolt them in. Now, we're not bolting it because we want it to move, we're bolting it because we actually like the look of the bolts. Do remember, of course, that lots of the devices can be made visible or invisible, and keeping them visible can actually be part of your decoration sometimes. So here we can see these bolts, which look like they've nailed that chain link fence to the boiler. Now we're going to put some windows in now. We are inserting here, this is on the back layer. We're going to put a circle of wood, and then inside that we're going to put a circle of glass, which is going to give us that nice porthole effect. Again, if you're going to do any of this, stick it onto front view to make sure you're getting these exactly in the right place, and of course keep the grid on. So there's the structure of our boat. Let's add some special effects in part two. I'll see you then.